Good afternoon. I am Mr. Ish. Thank you for joining me for this video on difficult domains. Difficult over here, a matter of perspective and a subjective term. Could be difficult for some, it could be easy for some, or it could be moderate in terms of difficulty for many. F of x is equal to square root of x squared minus 9. You know what a domain is, the set of possible x values, your inputs which will satisfy the function in terms of generating a valid output. Something you can put in here and you can get a good answer, a good legitimate output that represents an item from your domain. How do you go about determining this? A good way is if you just pluck out this x squared minus 9 and you equal it to 0, you can go from there and you have x is equal to plus and minus 3. That tells you that somewhere on a number line, minus 3 and then a 0 in between and a 3, it tells you at some point this minus 3 and 3 are involved. Now your determination is everything in between involved? Is everything involved or is everything only on the ends or in the extremes involved? When you look at this specific equation, take the number 0 for instance and put 0 in here and you'll get a item here with a minus 9. If you put 0 in here, you're getting a negative value in terms of a square root. You know you cannot do that because we're not talking about imaginary numbers. Therefore, it gives you an idea that everything in between here is not involved. So just take a number at the end. If you take it like a 10 or a minus 10 and you put them in here, you always have a positive in terms of the square root and you're looking at something like this in terms of your domain. Everything on either ends of these two numbers, including these two numbers, and you can write your domain in this way, minus infinity up to minus 3, including minus 3. And then you jump across and then 3 including 3 up to infinity, and that right there would be your answer to this question, and it should be right. And it will be right. But contrast this question here with something like this, 9 minus x squared. You see how they look rather similar, but they're entirely different in terms of domain. When you look at this, and then you start plugging in these numbers like 0 and then 10 and then a minus 10, you'll get opposite results. When you put these numbers in between, it satisfies your domain. But when you put these numbers at the ends, you get a negative in your square root. When you have something which looks like this, here now your domain is minus 3 to 3, including either of these, but none of the other numbers on either sides would be part of your domain because you'd get a negative in your square root. And remember, you can do a square root of a 0 and that's right. There's nothing wrong with doing a square root of a 0, it's equal to a 0. Your problem is you don't want to be doing a square root, an even root of a negative number, because that's undefined for the purposes of domain. So this question is done. This right here is your answer. Let's look at this one. 2x plus 1 divided by x squared minus 4. How do you go about doing a determination for domain for a rational function? You can always start by doing factoring because then it tells you what you are looking at in terms of your zeros. Because you want to determine the zeros, they'll help you determine if there are any asymptotes involved, vertical asymptotes. If you have a vertical asymptote involved, it's not included in your domain. When you look over here for your zero, you have x is equal to 2 and minus 2. These are your vertical asymptotes, VA, vertical asymptotes. It would tell you that you cannot put a 2 or a minus 2 here in terms of this specific function because you'll end up zeroing out the denominator. You'll have a situation where you'll have some number here on the top divided by 0 and that's undefined. You can't do that. So you already know these two cannot be in your domain, but you have to determine if somehow the presence of this numerator expression corrupts your function in any way, and it wouldn't. If you put a minus number here, you're fine. If you put a 0 over here, you're fine. If you put 0, what would you get? F of 0, you'll have a 1 over minus 4, and you'll have a minus 1 over 4, which is fine. There's nothing wrong with minus 1 over 4. That's a perfectly legitimate value. So it ends up showing you that very likely your domain is all real numbers, but none of these. You can write your domain as this. X is an element of all real numbers, but x cannot equal to 2 or minus 2. Or you can write your answer in this way, minus infinity up to minus 2, circular parentheses, because you're not including it. Then you can also do minus 2 up to 2, circular parentheses, and then you can jump, and then you do 2 up to infinity. This right here is a good way of representing the same expression right over here. This right here is your domain, this right here is your domain. They both mean the same thing, but they're expressed in different ways, and your answer would be good. Just as an added thing here, you're looking here at a vertical asymptote of x equals 2, x equals minus 2, but you have a higher in terms of the order of exponents in the denominator and the lower in the numerator, you'll have a horizontal asymptote. Your horizontal asymptote here will be y equals 0, and you can refer to the horizontal asymptote video. Here my n value was equal to 1, m was equal to 2, n was less than m, therefore you have this. Your x-axis of y equals 0 would be your horizontal asymptote. If you were to do a rough graph of just the asymptotes, x equals minus 2, vertical asymptote, x equals 2, another vertical asymptote, y equals 0, your x-axis is your horizontal asymptote. Two vertical, one horizontal asymptote, and your function will do something here in between. You can always generate tables of values, and you'll end up seeing here, in terms of a 0, I have, when I plug in here, I have a minus 1 over 4, a y-intercept somewhere right over here. Is this just a rough estimation? You'll probably have a graph which will look like that. Additional points will help you determine that you're looking at something like this. And that right there would be your curve. It would be separated into three separate parts by means of these two vertical asymptotes. And that would be perhaps a good depiction of what this function would look like. Anyhow, the domain over here is exactly this right here, or this right here, and the domain should be just fine. And that's it for this particular video. Thank you for watching. Have a good day.